الحمد لله رب العالمين، حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه كما يحب ربنا ويرضى. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله، صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. أما بعد، فأيها المؤمنون عباد الله، it is quite late and we have benefited greatly from the visit of our noble brothers, Abu Fajr and Abu Sulaiman. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward them for what they have put forward from khayr. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward all of those who took part, those who traveled with them, and those who have attended. But seeing that it was requested that Nasiha has put forward, inshallah, it will be concise. Hoping from Allah Azza wa Jalla tawfiq wa tasdeed. So from we heard in the prayer, this is a statement of the Imam when reciting the Fatiha, اهدنا الصراط المستقيم, guide us to the straight path. And this was preceded by a number of thana'at, a number of praises to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As it comes in the hadith of Abi Huraira and Muslim, when the servant says, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, يقول الله حمدني عبدي, my servant, he has praised me. And if he says Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says أثنى علي عبدي, my servant has extolled me. And if he says مالك يوم الدين, Allah عز وجل says مجدني عبدي, my servant, he has glorified me, he has magnified me. And then when he says إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين, he says هذا بيني وبين عبدي ولعبدي ما سأل, this is between me and my servant he will get what he has asked. So there's a number of praises before invoking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We take from this an etiquette in the dua and supplication that before going into your dua, start by praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the ulama also mentioned from the etiquettes of the dua is as-salah wa salam ala nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then you supplicate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And what you're asking him for is to guide you to the straight path. This Sirat al-Mustaqim that we're asking repeatedly and repeatedly in every salah that we're praying. In fact, the salah is not valid without the Fatiha. La salata liman lam yaqra bi fatihati al-kitab, the hadith of Ubadah in Bukhari and Muslim. There is no prayer for the one who does not recite the Fatiha. And every time you're still asking Allah Azza wa Jalla to guide you to the straight path. Ibn Jawzi rahimahullah, he mentions four aqwal, four opinions among the people of knowledge as to what is intended by this Sirat al-Mustaqim. He mentions the kitab. You're asking Allah Azza wa Jal to guide you to his book. Some have said, huwa deenullah. You're asking Allah to guide you to his religion. Some have said, al-tariq al-hadi ilallah, the path that guides you to Allah. And some have said, tariq al-jannah, the path to paradise. And this is what the ulama refer to as khilaf al-tanawwur. Yani they're all pointing to a juz, a part of what this sirat al-mustaqim entails. And all of these meanings are correct together. And what this is in essence that you're asking Allah Azza wa Jal to guide you to is ma kana alayhi nabiyuna Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa sahabatu, what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his companions were upon. This is what we're asking Allah repeatedly to guide us to. Allah says innaka ala al-haqq al-mubin, wa Muhammad, you're upon the truth in clarity. La shakka wa la rayb, there's no doubt about it that what the Prophet was upon was al-haqq al-mubin. And this is what you're asking Allah repeatedly to guide you to. And a person may say, as a question is put forward, how can you be asking Allah for hidayah? Are the Muslimun not muhtadun? Are they not already guided? Why are they asking for guidance? Ibn al-Jawzi mentions this again in Zad al-Masir. And he says that what is intended here is either a tathbeet, we're asking Allah to keep us firm upon the truth, or we're asking Allah Azza wa Jal for an increase of the truth, or we're asking Allah Azza wa Jal for luzum, that he keeps us firm upon the truth and upon this straight way. This is what we're asking Allah Azza wa Jal. And this has an asr fi sunnah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this is dua, as it comes in the hadith of Ibn Mas'ud fi Sahihain. Allahumma inni as'aluka al-huda wa al-tuqa wa al-afaf wa al-ghina. Oh Allah, I ask you for guidance. I ask you for taqwa. I ask you for afaf, to be chaste, to be modest, wa al-ghina, and to be self-sufficient. The true richness is the richness of the heart. So how is Rasulullah asking for hidayah wa huwa imam al-muhtadeen? How is he asking for guidance and he is the leader of those who are guided? What is intended by this hadith is مزيداً, asking for an increase of the guidance. And this is what we're always in need of. فَاسْتَشْعِرْ هَذَا أَيُّ الْعَبْدِ, So reflect upon this when you're reciting the Fatiha, that you're asking Allah to keep you firm and to increase you and to make you adhere to this Sirat al-Mustaqim, this straight way, this guidance that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came with. And you're treading that path to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Sirat al-Mustaqim, it's not going to be a piece of cake. It's not a walk in the park. It's going to be filled with trials. لِيَتَبَيَّنَ الصَّادِقُ مِنَ الْكَاذِبِ وَنَبْلُوكُمْ بِالشَّرِّ وَالْخَيْرِ فِتْنَ وَإِلَيْنَا تُرْجَعُونَ Allah says, we will trial you with evil and good trials, and to us is your return. So there must be this shaking in order for it to become clear. الْخَبِيثُ مِنَ الطَّيِّبِ Those who are good and sincere and their claim to Islam from those who are liars. And what shows this is the hadith of Ibn Mas'ud collected by Ahmad in his Musnad, وهو حديث صحيح. And the Nabiya sallallahu alayhi wa sallam khatta. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he drew a straight line. ثم قال هذا سبيل الله. He said, this is the path of Allah. ثم خط عن يمينه وشماله خطوطا. Then he drew lines on the right and the left of that path. And he said, هذه السبل. These are the pathways. These are the pathways. وعلى كل سبيل منها شيطان يدعو إليه. And every single one of those paths, they have a shaitan that is calling to it. Then he recited the statement of Allah, وَأَنَّ هَذَا سِرَاطِ مُسْتَقِيمًا فَاتَّبِعُوا That this is my straight path, so follow it. وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا السُّبُلِ And do not follow those other paths. فَتَفَرَّقَ بِكُمْ عَنْ سَبِيلِهِ As it will misguide you from the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If we were to take a waqfa and pause just to reflect over the meanings, the powerful meanings that this hadith entails. The Prophet, he drew the straight line. And then he drew lines diverting from the right and the left of that line. And he said that every one of those lines is pathways of the devils, they're calling to it. You benefit from this. كُلُّ دَعْوَى لَيْسَتْ الْقُرْآنُ وَالسُّنَّةِ عَلَى مَا كَانَ عَلَيْهِ نَبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ فَالْحَقِيقَةَ أَنَّ وَرَاءَهَا شَيْطَانُ Every call that's not upon the Qur'an and the Sunnah, and the understanding of the Salaf is Salih, what the Prophet came with, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then at the end of it, there is a shaitan. It can be a person who is wearing garments of Islam, outwardly praying with you, whatever they may be manifesting from the Islamic etiquettes and apparel and mannerisms. Lakin, if that call in essence is opposing what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was upon, then you know, and we're talking about the masail that are usul, masail in the aqidah, and the masail that are fundamental issues of the religion. We're not talking about masail khilafiyah that the ulama have continued to differ from the time of the sahaba. We're talking about masail aqadiyah, matters of creed and belief in Allah Azza wa Jal. Then you know that there's a shaitan at the end of that path calling the people to it. And look where the shaitan sits. This was the promise that he made to Allah. قَالَ فَبِمَا أَغْوَيْتَنِي لَأَقْعُدَنَّ لَهُمْ صِرَاطَكَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ Because you misguided me, I will sit for them on your straight path. The shaitan is not sitting at the pubs. He's not sitting at the liquor shops. He's not sitting at your business. He's not sitting at wherever people are. Besides this straight path, he's waiting there. لَأَقْعُدَنَّ لَهُمْ صِرَاطَكَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ ثُمَّ لَآتِيَنَّهُمْ مِنْ بَيْنِ أَيْدِيهِمْ وَمِنْ خَلْفِهِمْ وَعَنْ أَيْمَانِهِمْ وَعَنْ شَمَائِلِهِمْ وَلَا تَجِدُ أَكْثَرَهُمْ شَاكِرِينَ And I will come to them from the front and the back and the right and the left, and you will find many of them not to be thankful. This is the result of following the shaitan. You find very few people thankful for the ni'am that Allah has blessed them with. The likes of this majlis that we're in today, the likes of this standing, being healthy, being able to gather as Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah and a house from the houses of Allah and listen to khair. Wallahi, hada yahtaj ila shukr. This necessitates for us to be thankful. Walakin, how many of us are thankful? Wa qalilu min ibadiyya shakur. So the devil, he made this promise that he would sit on that straight path. And we know that there are callers to Jahannam, as it comes in the hadith of Hudhayfa fi sahih. When he asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, saying, إِنَّكَ أَتَيْتَنَا بِخَيْرٍ فَهَلْ بَعْدَ هَذَا الْخَيْرٍ مِنْ شَرٍ You brought us good. Is there after this good, evil? He said, نعم. And from the things that he mentioned sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was دُعَاتٌ عَلَىٰ أَبْوَابِ جَهَنَّمْ Callers who will be at the doors of the hellfire. مَنْ أَجَابَهُمْ إِلَيْهَا قَذَفُهُمْ فِيهَا Whoever answers their call will be cast into the hellfire with them. So they are going to be du'at إِلَىٰ أَبْوَابِ جَهَنَّمْ Callers to the hellfire. And the Prophet described them as being min bani jildatina wa yatakallamuna bi alsinatina. They call, they speak the same language, they're from the same people. They're fi dhahir al Islam. What is apparent from them is they're Muslims. But what does their call lead to? It calls to the hellfire. عباد الله, this is a danger that we are living today. كثرة الدعاء, many callers to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we put this in quotations. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows what is the intent of the person and what is in their heart. But there are many, many callers out there. Look at what's available on YouTube and the social media. You have female callers even. Female callers out publicly calling to the path of Allah, recording themselves. How many mukhalafat are there which are opposing what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his sahaba were upon? So what are you to do at this time? You're looking for that guidance. It is upon you to make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to invoke Allah sincerely so that Allah azza wa jalla directs you to that khair. He guides you and directs you to the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And we're not talking about the innovations which are wadiha, the bid'ah of tashayyu', the bid'ah of tama'shul, the way of the Asha'ira, the way of the Maturidiyya, the way of the Jahmiyya, of old and new. In fact, you even have Mu'tazila that are present, propagating the creed of the Mu'tazila. Yani, we're not talking about that. We're talking about more so, let's make the circle even more narrow. Those who say we're upon the Quran and the Sunnah. The Quran and the Sunnah. Ibadallah, there is a three-headed monster that is destroying many of the Shabab and the Shabat today. The males and the females, they're being destroyed by a three-headed monster. Under the guise of Quran was Sunnah, way of the Salaf. One is Al-Ghulu. One of those heads is Ghulu, extremism. Being extreme in the deen. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, كما في حديث ابن مسعود في مسلم هلك المتنطعون هلك المتنطعون هلك المتنطعون. Those who are extreme, they're destroyed. والتكرار يدل على توكيد الأمر. And this repetition is only to emphasize the gravity of the matter. Those who are extreme, whether they're openly extreme, calling to khuruj and rebellion against a Muslim ruler who's sinful, or less than that, yani you find aspects of extremism which are present. Al-hajr, al-dayiq, if you're with us, then alhamdulillah. If you're not with us, or you don't take from so-and-so and so-and-so, think another, you're questionable. Your manhaj is questionable. يا أخي أنا أتكلم بما أرى. يعني I believe this is a mistake. Can I raise my concern? Can I put forward my concern? Why is this man a da'i? 25 years in da'wah. طيب, where's your credentials? من زكاك من أهل العلم وقال أنت عالم أو أنت طالب علم. Who called you a scholar? Who said you're a student of knowledge? I'm raising my concerns. Cure my concerns so I can take from you. This is deen. إن هذا العلم دين فانظروا عمن تأخذون دينكم. This knowledge, it is your religion. Look to where you're taking your religion from. Any concerns raised? لا. You can't speak about so-and-so. You can't be like this. You have an issue. You have to make tawbah. If you're with us, you're with us. If you're not with us, المقاطعة. This is حزبية بعينها. الولاء والبراء ضيق. This restricted manner of loyalty and disassociation. Not based on Quran and Sunnah, based on individuals. Based on individuals. أين هذا؟ أين هذا في القرآن والسنة؟ Bring me proof of the way of the Salaf that promotes this and calls to it. And what leads to this type of غلو is حب الدنيا حقيقة. حب الدنيا. The one who chases after the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said in the hadith of Ka'ab bin Malik, ما ذئبان جائعان أرسل في غنم بأفسد لها من حفظ المرء على مال وشرف لدينه. It's collected by Tirmidhi and others. Authentic hadith. That two hungry wolves let loose on a flock of sheep, they will not do more damage to those sheep than if a person chases after wealth and fame, what they will do to his religion. Yani the wolf is a vicious animal. It's a vicious predator. It will kill this, break that, harm this, poke that. So you chasing after wealth, chasing after honor and fame and wealth and these kind of matters of the dunya, they will do more damage to your religion than the wolf will do to a flock of sheep. Ibadallah, this is from the things that lead to this. For this reason, Allah Azza wa Jalla says, تِلْكَ الدَّارُ الْآخِرَةِ نَجْعَلُهَا لِلَّذِينَ لَا يُرِيدُونَ عُلُوًا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَلَا فَسَادًا وَالْآقِبَةُ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. That is the home of the hereafter. We have made it for those who do not want any elevation in this life. They're not seeking elevation. وَلَا فَسَادًا or corruption. And the عَاقِبَةُ, the end is for the muttaqeen. The end will always be from the muttaqeen. So this is one matter which is there, this extremism in the conduct. يعني الأخطاء تعالج بالقرآن والسنة. The mistakes are to be rectified with Quran and Sunnah. Somebody made a mistake. يا أخي, you made this mistake. يا أخي, this is a دليل for it. يعني, I have to present it to you, hoping good. أدينه نصيحة. نعم. وليتراجع من أخطأ. يعني, everyone should be humble before Allah Azza wa Jal. This is the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If a child was to come to you and say, you made this mistake, the way you stood for the prayer was incorrect, or whatever you did was wrong, the way you performed the takbir, it was wrong, then we should be humble and accept it for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal. But this extremism in the deen, this is one danger. Another danger, the second head of that monster, is the opposite of this, the total other end of the spectrum, which is at-tafriyat, being negligent, or you can say at-tamayyur in modern terms. Sheikh Mubali used to use this word, at-tamayyur, watering down the religion, softening the religion. Hey, akhi, we're too harsh. Akhi, we need to welcome the people. We need to welcome, how are the da'wah going to reach the Sufis? How is the da'wah going to reach these people? Let's go to their places. Let's share panels with them. We're calling them. Then what happens? Hatta yadi'u al-shabab. The youth are lost. They have no clear understanding of the way of the Salaf anymore, because of the likes of these du'at. لا يوضحون سيرهم. They're not able to outwardly say, wallahi, you're upon Sufism. And I believe, as deen, that Sufism is not the way of Allah, that this is the bid'ah muhdatha. They have a difficulty in doing this. And what does it lead to? Men and women, young and old, being lost because they have husn al-dhan for these du'at. This is another mushkila that we're facing. This negligence and this tafreet and shortcoming in the way we present our da'wah. It must be balanced. It must be balanced. وَكَذَلِكَ جَعَلْنَاكُمْ أُمَّةً وَسَطًا لِتَكُونُوا شُهَدَاءَ لِلنَّاسِ وَيَكُنَ الرَّسُولُ عَلَيْكُمْ شَهِيدًا. Allah, when He made us a ummah wasata, an upright nation. يعني the ulama mentioned the hadith, هو في الصحيح, عدلٌ خيار, just upright people. This is what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he explained this ummah wasata as being. We have to be upright, we have to be just. نَزِّنُ الْأُمُورِ بِمَوَازِينِهَا الشَّرْعِيَّةِ. We weigh the matters in a legislated manner, returning things back to the Quran and to the Sunnah. This is what is required. Allah Azza wa Jal says, فَاسْتَقِمْ كَمَا أُمِرْتَ وَمَنْ تَابَ مَعَكَ وَلَا تَطْغَوْ إِنَّهُ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ بَصِيرٌ. فَاسْتَقِمْ, be upright, O Muhammad, كَمَا أُمِرْتَ, as you have been ordered. What do you take from this? Being upright as you have been ordered, not the way you want, but how Allah ordered. This negates being negligent. It negates this tamayyu in the religion. كَمَا أُمِرْتَ أَنْتَ وَمَنْ تَابَ مَعَكَ, and those who have repented along with you, O Muhammad. وَلَا تَطْغَوْ, and do not be extreme. This is the other end. Allah Azza wa Jalla, He has perfected our deen for us, gave us all the tools that we need to worship Him so that we're able to tread that Sirat al-Mustaqim correctly. And the third head of this monster is حُبُّ الدُّنْيَا, chasing after the worldly life, chasing after fame. This is another danger which is destroying the youth more than anyone else. If I'm a person, they will go out, everyone wants a social media account. Everyone wants to be recorded. Everyone wants to have some form of fame. Everyone wants some form of recognition. What is this doing? This is affecting the ikhlas. وَمَا أُمِرُوا إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ. They were only ordered to worship Allah, making their religion sincerely for Allah. This is a danger which is there. It is harming the communities. People are in the households complaining about their wives. My wife, she has this issue. She's always online. I told her before I got married to stop recording herself. She said yes, and now she does it secretly. What should I do? These are realities. Wallahi, these are realities which have happened. And people are asking questions about this. Why? Because of that recognition and wanting to be seen and wanting to be heard. مَنْ سَمَّعَ سَمَّعَ اللَّهُ بِهِ وَمَنْ يُرَاءِ يُرَاءِ اللَّهُ بِهِ. The hadith of Ibn Abbas and others for Sahihain. The one who says things to be heard and the one who shows himself to be seen, Allah will humiliate them. Allah will humiliate them. Are we seeking humiliation? For no one to see you, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He sees you. هذا يكفيك. هذا يكفيك. This is sufficient for you. The Rabbul Alameen, your creator, He sees your efforts, and He sees what's in your heart, and He sees the sincerity that you have, and your tamassuk بهذا المنهج السلفي. You cling on to this way of the Salaf, with your molar teeth for the sake of Allah. This is enough of recognition for you. Wallahi al-azim, if we only knew. A people, the Prophet told us, they will come. يجيئون يقيمونه كما يقام القدح. They will come and they will recite the Quran, straightening the Quran like an arrow. This is arrow before the leaves, the feathers are put on in the metal at the end. They will recite the Quran with such precision, with such talent. يتعجلونه ولا يتعجلونه. They seek the early reward in the dunya and they don't wait for it in the hereafter. Look at the danger of this. Abadullah will stop, inshallah, with a story, a true story, and one of the experiences I had, showing, يعني في الزوايا خبايا كما يقال. In the corners, there are hidden things. Only Allah knows them. First, it's important for us to know is a principle that we're not going to ever understand and know all of the ulama that have walked the earth. But that does not mean that they do not have their status and value with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Maybe the amount of scholars that we know in our lives, we can count them on our hands. ولكن there are ulama and there are mashaykh and there are people who sacrifice themselves for the sake of Allah azza wa jal. And this story is about an individual, أحسبه كذلك والله حسيبه. I perceive he's like this and Allah knows best. One time in a journey, we were doing da'wah, we went to the middle of nowhere in a region called Mirti, which is in Kenya. This is in a deep, deep central, towards central. Anyway, you have to take the rough, you're on the rough for maybe 10 hours, let alone your other journey to get to that place. Village in the middle of nowhere. So we went there, we were doing da'wah with some of the ikhwa, akhuna, Abu Sama, Farah, and some of the ikhwa, they accompanied us, Jazakumullah khairan, and they invited us actually to join them in this journey. We went on the journey, ala itihalin, we got to the place. So there was a majlis, we sat in a majlis like this before the Salatul Jumu'ah. Outside of the masjid, they requested a kalima, we gave them nasaih, it was being translated to their mother tongue. Then we divided ourselves, we went to different masajid for the purpose of da'wah. So on the way to one of the masajid, we went by a house of a man. The person driving the vehicle, he said, هذا مؤسس الدعوة هنا. He said, this is the man who has founded da'wah here. He's founded da'wah here. So usually, coming from Yemen, coming from the Marakiz of Ilm, when you hear مؤسس da'wah, you don't understand where to put this on the table. يعني, did he bring jam'iyat? Did he bring charity organizations? Did he just establish Marakiz? Did he just build masajid? I didn't understand exactly where to put this. I said, let me see what happens. He got on the vehicle, we went together. So before he got on the vehicle, he told me this man is mashur. He has sihr done on him. Elderly man came on the vehicle with us, we went to the masjid. Did the khutbah. After the khutbah, he got up. He gave advice in their language. Then we ended up finishing our program there, returned back. On the way back, this is where the story comes in. On the way back, I was met by another man in some other village. And he said, did you meet a man called Abdullah Gualicha? I said, yeah, I met him. He said to me, that man, do you know his story? I said, no, I don't know his story. He said, that village that you are in, that village, it was overtaken by Christians, I believe Catholics. The Catholic denomination came to that village, which was Muslim. It was a Muslim village. And they turned them into Christians by way of a tamweel, wealth building, hospitals, pumps, different things were placed in order to draw the people in. And many of the people left Islam to Christianity because of the dunya. This is the danger which is out there. Alaytihal, he said that man, Abdullah that you met, he came back from his studies abroad. I may have been Saudi, I don't know where he went. But he said he came back and he said, I will not get married while my people are like this. I will call them to the Tawheed of Allah. He began a one-handed fight against the Christians and the Kufar, who the Murtadun, calling them back to the Tawheed of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he would go to people, he said, and he would say, I don't want your money. Just build me a center so I can call to the Tawheed of Allah. And he got assistance like this. He continued to call and fight against them and call and fight against them until he said 80% of those people who became murtadun, they came back to Islam. 80%. No social media, nothing. The village has nothing. I don't even know how strong the internet was there, the connection. Ala itihalin, he, through the efforts and being sincere to Allah and calling to Tawheed, his people came back to the Tawheed of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Christians had no room to remain in the village. What did they do? They packed up and left. Allahu Akbar. They packed up and left the village. And then they did sihr on him. So remember I told you when we were going there, the man told me he had sihr done. This is from the Nasara. Intiqaman, taking revenge from him because of what he did. They did sihr on him. Which he's still facing, Allahu Alam, if he's been cured. But a person like that, نحن لا نعرفه. No one knows who this man is. لكن الله يعلم ما هو عليه. Allah knows what he is upon. Allah knows what he is upon. So ibadallah, it's not for today. It's not for today. It's for 100 years when you're in your grave. 200 years, 300. Allahu alam. How long we will be in our qubur? The affair is for your future, your real future. Istaiddu lima ba'd al-maut. Prepare for what is after death. And let us not be taken by these calls that are peeling apart the way of Ahlul Sunnah and setting people against each other and ask questions. What's the dalil? You said this statement. What's the proof for this? Return back to the understanding of the Salaf. This is what will be a safety for us, bi-idhnillahi azza wa jal. وَخُذْ مِنْ أَهْلِ الْخَيْرِ. The likes of these du'at, يعني, from the sign of a caller who's upon khayr, يعني, they're not seeking people's money through it. لَا أَسْأَلُكُمْ عَلَيْهِ مِنْ أَجْرٍ إِنْ أَجْرِي إِلَّا عَلَى رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. This is the way of the prophets. I don't seek any wealth. My reward is with Allah, رَبَّ الْعَالَمِينَ. This is the way of the prophets. This is a sign of khayr, bi-idhnillahi azza wa jal. So ibad Allah, stick to the likes of Ahl al-Khayr that you see upon the sunnah, these brothers and the other du'a that we know upon the sunnah. And it doesn't mean that this is the only Ahlul Sunnah. But weigh the person's statements and actions upon the Quran and Sunnah. And you'll be able to tell what kind of person they're upon, what kind of person they are and what they're upon. And this is also the advice the likes of Mu'adh bin Jabal. We mentioned this athar not long ago. When death came, uhtudhira. It's in the Musnad of Imam Ahmad. When death came to Mu'adh, qila lahu awsina. They said, Mu'adh, give us advice. He said, إِنَّ الْعِلْمَ وَالْإِمَانَ مَكَانَهُمَا. Knowledge and iman, they're in their place. مَنْ ابْتَغَاهُمَا وَجَدَهُمَا. Whoever seeks them will find them. وَالْتَمِسَ الْعِلْمَ عِنْدَ أَبِي دَرْدَى أَبِي دَرْدَى وَيْمِرْ. Seek knowledge from Abu Darda وَيْمِرْ. والسلمان الفارسي وعبد الله بن مسعود وعبد الله بن سلام الذي كان يهوديا فأسلم. He mentioned four. معاذ بن جبل, who died in the Ta'un of Amawas, radiallahu anhum ajma'een. These are our leaders. Ulaika abai faji'ni bimithlihim. These are our leaders. Bring the likes of them to us. Fa'ibadallah, this is a reminder for myself firstly and for the noble ikhwa, al-fudala, and those who are present, that we cling on to this manhaj al-salafi sidqan, to the best of our ability. We are truthful with Allah Azza wa Jal, sirran wa alanan. And we love this deen more than anything else. Hoping that Allah Azza wa Jal rewards us for this. Walhamdulillahi awwalan wa akhiran wa zahiran wa batinan wa salli lahumma wa sallim wa barik ala nabiyyina Muhammad.